Hello everyone, welcome to Ambient. So guys, you have few questions on your board, and if you really think that you can solve this question easily, skip this video or else stay with me for next 5 to 7 minutes and we'll see that how to solve this kind of question easily. So guys, this is Mihir. Let's get started. Now, before we solve these kind of question, we need to know some basic concept of negative remainder. So wo pehle dekhte hain, tab aayenge questions pe. Now guys, if I ask you that when 6 is divided by 4, so what will be the remainder? So remainder is going to be positive 2, right? Now when I talk about the negative remainder, so when 6 is divided by 4, what is going to be the negative remainder here? Now what do I mean by negative remainder? Now, ab batao yahan pe 6 ke jagah pe agar 8 rehta, to this would have been completely divisible, right? But agar yahan pe 6 hai, to this is what? 2 less than, hai na, the actual number. So, agar 8 rehta, to completely divide ho jata, but 6 hai, to ye completely divide nahi ho raha hai. To I can also say that this is minus 2 less than. Right? So guys, actually में negative remainder का कोई concept नहीं होता है. Whenever we get any negative remainder, what we do is, we add it to the divisor to get the actual remainder. So let's say मैंने इसे 4 से add कर दिया. So what do I have now? I have positive 2 as the remainder, as the first case. ठीक है? एक और example ले लेते हैं. Let's say मैंने बोला कि 5 divided by 3 करो, तो actual remainder जो positive remainder होता है, still positive 2 होगा. Right? And if I ask you to find out the negative remainder, so 5 upon 3 करोगे तो कितना आएगा negative remainder? So basically अगर यहाँ पे 6 होता, तो it would have been completely divisible, right? But 6 से कितना कम है? 1 कम है, right? So I have minus 1 as the negative remainder. So I know that I cannot leave my remainder as minus 1. So what do I need to do? I need to add it to the divisor. So मैंने 3 से add कर दिया यहाँ पे, तो मुझे कितना मिल गया? 2, which was the actual remainder in the first case. So I hope सभी को ये समझ में आ गया होगा कि negative remainder क्या है. Now इसका concept अब देखेंगे अपने questions पे जो हमने पहले देखा था. Now coming down to our actual question, so guys कुछ concepts देख लेते हैं. Now let's say if I tell you that 2 factorial plus 1 will always be divided by 3. ये हमेशा होता है. अगर तुम चेक करोगे, let's say 4 factorial plus 1 will be completely divided by 5. Now actual guys, यहाँ पे हो क्या रहा है, ये चेक करते हैं. Now p minus 1 factorial plus 1 will always be divisible by p when p is a prime number. Always remember that when p is prime number. So इसी condition में ये true होगा. तो अगर तुम देख रहे हो पहले एग्जांपल में 3 was my prime number and 5 my was a prime number basically. So हमने दोनों केस में देखा था, this entirely was the multiple of 3 and this entirely was the multiple of 5. ठीक है? और it was completely divisible by 5 and completely divisible by 3. Same case यहाँ पे भी हो रहा है, अगर p minus 1 factorial plus p है, which will be completely divisible by p when it is a prime number. ठीक है? Now, so अब इससे क्या drive कर सकते हैं? ये देख लेते हैं यहाँ पे. So कॉन्सेप्ट नंबर 1 अगर यहां पे चेक करते हैं, नाउ लेट्स से गाइस, इफ आई टेल यू दैट व्हाट विल बी द रिमाइंडर व्हेन p minus 1 फैक्टोरियल विल बी कंप्लीटली डिवाइडेड बाय p. अब ओके, द कंडीशन रिमेंस द सेम दैट p विल बी अ प्राइम नंबर. ठीक है? नाउ अगर हमने फर्स्ट केस में देखा था p minus 1 plus 1 वाज कंप्लीटली डिवाइडेड बाय p, राइट? बट हम यहां पे जब आके देखते हैं, देयर इज 1 इज मिसिंग आउट हियर, राइट? सो 1 इज मिसिंग आउट हियर, तो इसका रिमाइंडर क्या हो जाएगा? द नेगेटिव remainder होगा, that is minus 1. So guys, अब मुझे पता है कि negative remainder का तो कोई concept होता नहीं है, तो I need to add the divisor to it, so outcome will be minus 1 plus p. So always remember that whenever you have question like this, like p minus 1 factorial divided by p and they ask you to find the remainder, so your answer is always going to be p minus 1 itself. ठीक है? कुछ example देख लेते हैं. Let's say if they ask you find remainder when 10 factorial is divided by 11. So first thing you need to check is 11 a prime number? Yes. Okay. So now, is it this condition? Yes. So my answer is always going to be p minus 1. That is, my remainder is always going to be 10 itself. Now we call it as a Wilson theorem. So I hope ye concept sabhi ko samajh mein aa gaya. This was the concept number 1. So let's see more concept related to it. Now, coming down to the further concept. Now guys, abhi tak humne kya sikha? That p minus 1 factorial mod p will always give me the remainder as p minus 1 itself. So mod is nothing but it's same as divisible. So when you divide or the mod, you can write any of them. Now guys, if you have a question something like this, let's say 9 factorial mod 11, and they're asking you to find the remainder. Or they might also give you this question something like this: 9 factorial upon 11 and find the remainder. Kuch aisa question de diya. Now how to deal with these kind of question? Now I know that 10 factorial mod 11, so my remainder is 10, I know that, right? So I can calculate this 10 factorial as 10 into 9 factorial mod 11, right? Or this question, you can also this modify something like this here. So this is nothing but 10 into 9 factorial upon 11. So what you have to calculate here, you actually want to find the remainder of this part, right? So this is the part which you want to calculate. So I'm taking this as R. So R is nothing but 1 itself. So tumhara remainder kitna aa gaya? 1 aa gaya remainder. So guys, ab yahan se kya calculate kar sakte hain aur kya conclude kar sakte hain? Whenever you have p minus 2 factorial mod p, so answer kya aata hai? Remainder will always going to be 1 itself. So whenever you have these kind of question, to hamesha solve kar sakte ho. Let's say you have 41 factorial mod 43 tumhe diya hua hai. Theek hai? So tumhe calculate kar, what will be the remainder here? Remainder is going to be 1 itself. So I hope is ye type of question mein bhi dikkat nahi hoga. So let's see some more concept related to it and more types of question. So, हमने दो टाइप के क्वेश्चंस देख लिए अभी तक. लेट्स से अगर तीसरा टाइप क्वेश्चन पूछा जाता है, लेट्स से इफ दे आस्क यू 8 फैक्टोरियल मॉड 11 एंड दे आस्क यू टू फाइंड द रिमाइंडर, और दे माइट आस्क यू समथिंग लाइक दिस, 8 फैक्टोरियल डिवाइडेड बाय 11 एंड दे माइट आस्क यू टू गेट द रिमाइंडर. सो फाइंड रिमाइंडर, दिस इज योर क्वेश्चन. सो इसे कैसे डील करोगे? नाउ आई नो दैट 10 फैक्टोरियल अपॉन 11, और इफ दे गिव यू 10 फैक्टोरियल mod 11, my answer is 10. We all know that. Okay, so 10 factorial mod 11, the remainder is 10. Fine. So I can split this into 10 into 9 into 8 factorial mod 11. Right. I have answered this as 10 itself. Ab mujhe pata hai mujhe remainder kiska nikalna hai? Mujhe remainder iska nikalna hai. So this is nothing but R here. Right. So agar tum guys iska remainder yahan calculate karoge, this will be nothing but minus 1, this is going to be minus 2, and this is R which you want to calculate, and this is nothing but 10. We have already got it from the first value. Theek hai? So R ka value yahan pe kitna aa jayega? This is nothing but 5 itself. Now wait, what you can conclude here? So whenever you have a question something like this, now p minus 3 factorial divided by p, and if they ask you to find the remainder, so what will be the value here? This is going to be nothing but p minus 1 upon 2. So this is always going to be your answer. Tum isme bhi calculate kar sakte ho, yahan pe mera kya tha, p is nothing but your 11 here, right? So this is nothing but 11 minus 1 upon 2, and 5 was my remainder. Theek hai? So I hope sabhi ko ye concept clear ho gaya hoga. And फर्दर अगर तुम जल्दी से कंक्लूड करना चाहते हो क्या हमने सीखा अभी तक, सो फर्स्ट हमने क्या सीखा था, p माइनस 1 फैक्टोरियल मॉड p, वी इज टू गेट व्हाट वैल्यू, रिमाइंडर इज टू बी p माइनस 1. दूसरा केस हमने देखा था व्हेन वी हैड p माइनस 2 फैक्टोरियल मॉड p, तो हमारा आंसर क्या होता था, दिस वॉज 1, राइट? सो हमने तीसरा केस क्या था, व्हेनेवर वी हैड p माइनस 3 फैक्टोरियल mod p, so हमने ऑलरेडी देख लिया यहाँ पे, this is nothing but p minus 1 upon 2. So whenever you have these kind of question, now remember this technique and you will be easily able to solve these kind of question. ठीक है guys, I hope you have learned something new here, and if you have liked the video, share it with your friends, those who are preparing, and I'm coming up with lot more new concepts, so stay tuned. Thank you guys.